Welcome, my name is Vishal Tekshanani. Today I'm speaking to Jake Klein, the Executive Chairman of Evolution Mining. Jake, always good to talk to you. How are you?
I'm great.
That's great. Lots going on in the gold market. Evolution just released its full year 2019 results. Talk us through the numbers and talk us through why profit fell, even though the gold price has strengthened since the last time we spoke.
So we produced 753,000 ounces at an all-in sustaining cost of $924 an ounce, which makes us one of the lowest cost gold producers in the world. But you're right, costs did go up this year. The copper price came down a little, which offset the gold price rise. And also costs inflation did bottom in FY18. So FY19, we did see power costs go up, and we did see some pressure on labor costs. The good news is that FY20, we are forecasting that we can offset any cost pressures with productivity and efficiency gains. So we forecast $890 to $940 as our all-in sustaining cost guidance for FY20, and 725,000 to 775,000 ounces. So still very low cost and delivering.
Okay. So the focus on low costs, and we'll talk about growth in a second. You've moved to a net cash position.
Yeah.
Remarkable achievement for a miner. Talk to us about your thinking around how to use this cash.
Well, let me first tell you how we got to that net cash position, because it's been a journey.
Yeah.
And over the last 5 years, we've transitioned and changed the portfolio. In 2015 and 16, we bought some terrific assets. When people were divesting, we bought from Glencore, we bought from Barrick, the Cowell and Ernest Henry interest. And the company really transformed. And our progress since then, in the last 5 years, we've generated $3 billion of operating cash flow. That's translated to $2 billion of net mine cash flow and $1.55 billion of free cash flow.
Yep.
So we've paid down $910 million of debt.
Yeah, wow.
We've built a cash balance of over $300 million, which has given us that net cash position. We've also paid, if you include this dividend that we've just declared, $459 million to shareholders. So we've used that cash, we're in that position. We're looking forward. That was all achieved at a gold price which is about $600 lower than the current spot price.
Wow, yeah.
So, we don't want to take a view on the gold price, but we want to remain disciplined and make sure we bank those dollars and ultimately either invest them prudently on behalf of our shareholders or give them back to our shareholders.
Okay. So you're going to be quite careful with M&A or shareholder returns, perhaps?
I think, as we've always said, we're going to be very disciplined.
Yeah.
We want to build a global mid-tier gold producer that is going to prosper through the cycle.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
I hope that the gold price is only starting its bull run, but I'm not going to bet on that.
Yeah.
So we use, for example, in our FY20 budgets, which is the next 12 months, we use a $1,750 gold price, and we use $1,350 for our reserves, which is very conservative.
Yeah.
So we want to be able to prosper through the cycle. I'm hoping the gold price is going up, but as our CFO, Laurie Conway, does a terrific job at managing the finances and keeping us disciplined, is focused on ensuring that that money gets banked, and ultimately determine whether we can deploy it on behalf of shareholders or pay it back.
Okay, so speaking of handing back capital to shareholders, you've had a change in your dividend policy. Do you want to talk through shareholders? What's the thinking behind that change?
So we've always said to our shareholders that we're custodians of their money, and if we can't find a way to invest it that is accretive to them, we should give it back to them.
Hmm.
And that was really behind the change in the policy. So we've gone from a 50% of after-tax profits policy to targeting 50% of our cash flow, our free cash flow before before debt repayments and dividends, and also looking at M&A opportunities before that and taking that into account. So really what we're saying is cash flow, our cash generation is more than our profits due to depreciation.
Yeah.
And we increased our dividend from a 4-cent final last year to 6 cents this year.
Mm.
And again, I emphasize that last year's gold price was 1760 average, and today's gold price is about $500 higher.
Yeah, wow. Okay, let's turn to growth initiatives.
Yeah.
It's a very exciting part of the cycle. The gold price has run very, very hard. I think investors are going to be asking, Jake, where are you going to pull even more gold from to capitalize on this high price?
We're going to focus on quality over volume.
Mm-hmm.
And that's always been our driver and our focus. We're producing gold at a 48% EBITDA margin, which is fantastic. And again, that was at a low gold price. So you can expect that margin to expand if the gold price stays higher.
Mm.
So what I'm very focused on is ensuring, can we invest that dollar in a way that improves the quality of our portfolio, or should we give it back to shareholders? We'll only do things that are accretive to our shareholders. We are investing more in exploration. We're spending between $80 and $105 million this year because of the success we're having at Cowal, some of the earliest signs of progress and promise at Mungari. And we're also looking at innovation and technology, which I think is a very exciting area and will add value to our business.
So Jake, investors in the gold sector and on NABTrade, they're looking at a lot of investment opportunities. There's Northern Star, Newcrest, etc. What makes Evolution stand out, would you say?
I think it's really our strategy and our people and our culture. And that culture is unique. It's something which I really think is special to Evolution, where we're trying our best. We're not there yet, but we try every day to make every person at Evolution feel empowered and engaged and part of our company, an important part of our company. Whatever job they're doing, we want them to feel that they're making a contribution to producing gold safely at Evolution.
All right, now let's turn to the gold price. Yeah. Before our interview, I loved that quote you made. The gold is the antidote to chaos, and we're certainly seeing a lot of chaos in the markets right now. Talk us through what your thinking is around the gold price, because investors are wondering, can this just keep continuing?
Well, we hope so. So I just want to caveat it that we hope so, and there are a lot of signs to believe that it is going higher, but we're not going to run our business that way. But there are a lot of reasons to be more positive gold. Unfortunately, they are somewhat the antidote to the chaos at the moment, because you know, you've got financial stress in the system. I think I've heard between $14 and $16 trillion of negative yielding debt, rising concerns of public and private debt. You've obviously got the geopolitical issues that we're reading about in our newspapers all the time. These are things that make gold, as the ultimate store of value, attractive again. I saw recently that Ray Dalio, the fund manager of the largest hedge fund in the world, is starting to recommend that gold may be a place to invest. So he hasn't been a gold bull in the past. And when people like Ray Dalio start talking about gold, I think others sit up and take notice.
Okay. Well, thank you for those fascinating insights, Jake. And it's certainly a lot for investors to consider. Thank you so much for your time and all the best with FY 2020.
Thanks very much. Always great speaking.
No worries. Thanks, Jake. I hope you enjoyed this video. Now, please remember what we talked about today isn't investment advice. If you're thinking about investing in Evolution Mining, gold securities, or any other security for that matter, it's really important that you make a considered investment decision and please consider seeking financial advice. My name is Vishal Teksanani and I'll see you next time.